Hi, I'm John Newton, aka Snap-on John 100, and you are watching Wilderness Self-Reliance. Today, I'm in Ithaca, and I'm going to be looking for Fatwood. And I'm also going to compare some of the one-handed fire starters that I have.
It is so gorgeous out here. I just had to take a moment to kind of show you what I'm seeing. These pines in front of me are Scots pines. You can tell that by up towards the top, they exfoliate their outer bark, and they look tan, like buckskin colored. I'm overlooking a river. I can't remember the name of it. Let's see if I can get there. Yeah, it's right there. The better view down here, right there. It is beautiful out. It's in the 80s, and I'm going to be going really slow and careful because I'm nursing a strained or inflamed ligament in my knee. I just can't seem to stop having mechanical injuries. I think it has to do with needing to lose more weight. So that's what I'm going to do. But I couldn't stand it any longer. I had to get out. It's such a gorgeous day. So today I'm out here looking for fatwood, and I know where there's a good area of pines. There's some pines here, but where I'm going, it's there's a lot more downed pines, so you can get to more of the dead wood to try to find it. Some more gorgeous scenery. I've also got some gear that I'm going to be checking out that I'm really fond of so far, and I want to put it on my website. One of the things I'm going to be carrying is Ribs chest packs. I think they're the best thing since sliced bread. Here's what I was talking about before, about keeping your eyes open. This dead tree right here, might be able to make a bird's nest out of the inner bark. And as you see, the answer pretty much is no. You could use that maybe in the center. But if you crumble it all up like this and it just kind of dissolves in your hand, that's not good bird's nest material.
but it sure looked like it might be.
It's so beautiful. And there's a really nice breeze now. So it's really getting hot. See how gorgeous this is? And the road, I'll show you where the road is. There's a bridge right there. Cars going over it. Just give you a panorama. I've only seen one other person here. They're walking a dog. I'm also experimenting with permethrin. I had issues with ticks the weekend before last with a scout outing. So I ordered permethrin, so I've sprayed my clothes. And then I put DEET on my skin, where anytime where my body exits any of my clothing, I put some DEET on my skin. So I'm just going to see how that works, mosquito-wise, too. I'm taking a break here. I'm going to get something to eat. So I was just showing you the rig I'm carrying. It's a Kelty MAP 3500, and I just got it. I don't know, about a month ago. I love it. It doesn't have 3,500 cubic inches in it, but it's really well made. The zippers are all YKK. The buckles are fantastic. The sewing is impeccable. It's just really nice. And the outside pockets actually hold Nalgene size containers. And the other thing I've got is my ribs chest pack. I'm also using Kelty trekking poles to help with my knee. And I wished I would have had them when I damaged my knee. These are pretty nice. They're really nice padded handles, and they lock right in here, so it's a pretty good locking mechanism. What I'm doing to find Fatwood is I'm going to a dead pine tree, and I'm sawing a branch off like this. Now, look at the end of it. Loaded. Look where I cut it off. So, this tree has got fatwood in every spot where it has branches. So, I'm just going to start chopping some of these out. All right. I dug a hole right here so I can prevent causing any issues. Plus, I want to leave no trace. But I've got three different fire starting methods. One is the blast match, and you open that by pulling back on this plastic catch and then folding it back on itself like this. This plastic catch is also where the striker is, and all that's holding that right there is that piece of plastic. That's its Achilles heel. I have heard of so many people snapping that off and then they just have a ferro rod. So that's a very major weak point for this, as far as I'm concerned. I haven't ever broken one because I don't use this very often. But
the way this works is you press down on this plastic piece, and that pushes a seal against the ferrocerium rod, and then you press down on it. And for this one to work, you have to press down on a surface. Well, it's not working. I gotta just put some bark in here so that it's not on the damp ground. So you just press down like this. Okay, I hope you saw that. I'll do it up here. Okay. The problem with that is a lot of times you knock your tinder out of the way, and you also have to have a hard surface. Like, I couldn't do this on just the dirt. So I'm not going to even bother lighting any tinder with this. I personally think this is a poor design, and I don't like it. Other people like it, I guess, but so that's the blast match. That's the same. There's another, they may have a smaller one too, Sparky or something. The next one is a Zippo one, and I have put, as you can see, a cross pattern. I put two Ranger bands on here because this is a Zippo lighter, but as you can see, there's a gasket inside, but there's nothing holding this lid on. So that's a flaw with this one. And the tinder in here is wax coated, and it is not waterproof. This will actually get wet and not work. So this gasket's gotta work. So that's why I fixed it by putting a Ranger band around where this seam is across here, and then one on the around the top and bottom to hold it down. Let's try this tinder. We'll just act like I've got one hand. Try flaring it out. And I'll put it right here. And this has got a direction wheel on it. So, right here, like this. So, I'm knocking that around. Let's see how one of my cotton balls lights. I didn't have a huge amount of success lighting that. Let me try one of my cotton balls. This is what I carry with me at all times. The nice thing about these is they do carry, there's room for four of these in there. Let's just see if I can ignite this thing. Got it. Okay. Now I'm going to put that out. All right. Let me see if I can light this if I hold it. There. I got it fuzzed out better. There it goes. That wasn't that easy to light. Okay, I'm just gonna save that. We know this will light, this thing will light cotton balls or its own stuff. But as you can see, you close that down and it doesn't snap closed. You gotta press it down. And that's what I came up with, is once I've pressed it down real hard, I put a Ranger band around that seam. To help keep water out. And then I put another one around top and bottom to force pressure on it to keep it closed. So if you do that, it's going to be good and waterproof. Okay, the third one, and it's by far my favorite, and there's three different styles, and that is the Sparklight Emergency Fire Starter. It was developed for American pilots. But you open this, and this one's aluminum, and you can get OD green or orange, but to me, I'd much rather have one that I could find easily, and this is already hard enough to see, anodized aluminum, but it's got arrows so you can tell that you strike this direction on it. And it comes in two aluminum models and a new brass one. That was the original. I really like the brass one. That's what they started with. And then there's also a plastic one. The plastic one is a throwaway one. It's the lightest. But the metal ones, there's a set screw in the bottom of them, and they come with an Allen wrench and a spare wick, or I mean a spare flint. And you can use the same flints like you would on a Zippo, but it comes with one spare one. So let's try this. This comes with Tinder Quick tabs, which these are waterproof. I've tried that by soaking it with water and then just kind of squeezing it out and then opening it up like this. And we'll see how easy that is. That's with left hand, which is my weak side. Make sure I'm doing it on the right direction. There it goes. So that took 5 or 6 tries, I think. I'm gonna put that out and save it. Now we'll try my cotton ball. This is where I love this one. Started. Every time, never fails. And this is a dream for anybody that uses a stove, because you just reach up there and spark this, like alcohol stove or some other kind of stove. You just spark it once and you've got it lit. So this is my favorite one. I'm gonna just see if I've got some shavings here. Right here, I'm gonna see if I can spark those. Gotta be really close too. That didn't spark that. But anyway, I like these so well that I'm carrying these on my website. I'm carrying all of the designs. The aluminum one, the brass one, and the plastic ones. Plastic also comes in orange or green. Comes in a nice box. It's got 8 of them in there. And then I'll also have replacement ones. And what I like to do is put a Ranger band on this just to make sure this doesn't pop open. unexpectedly, and you can also burn this. Here's the brass one. Here's the brass one. It's my favorite one. But it doesn't work any, it works the same as the other ones. The material doesn't really help that much, but I would rather have something that you keep rather than a throwaway model myself. But maybe for somebody that's ultralight backpacking, if they know they can get a plastic one, that's one that they would want. So I hope you liked that little demo of the one-handed fire starters. Once again, the blast match, I know there's a lot of people that like it, but for me, I give this about a 1 out of 10. I've never liked this style. I do like the Strike Force, but this one I just don't think is a very good design. I've seen too many people break off the plastic, because to open it up, you got to pull that back, and that's the direction it goes to break. So I don't think that design is very, very good. And then the next one, Zippo. I love Zippo products, that's why I have this one. But there's drawbacks with this that you got to pay attention to. By far my favorite is the Sparklight. And I am going to be carrying all these on my website. That is Wilderness Survival. I'm going to be carrying this on my website, and that's wildernessselfreliance.com. I'll put a note at the bottom. Brass and two colors of aluminum, and then there's two colors of plastic too. Well, I'm ready to cook. I'm going to be using my alcohol stove and my alcohol burner, I guess I should say, and my Pathfinder stove that goes with the round Pathfinder bottle. So I'm going to be using a combination like this with an alcohol burner under it. What I carry for, I carry it like this. I carry the alcohol stove, a cup, and it nests in my cook pot. This is a Stanley cook pot that I got at Walmart, and I took the cups that come with it out, and I keep my alcohol burner in there and a piece of Scotch-Brite to clean it up. So let me get this alcohol stove going. It's an Esbit. No, this is a Trangia. But just like it, Esbit's just like it. Esbit's made in Germany. Trangia is made in, I think, Switzerland. I'm not sure. But both of them have the same design, and they have O-rings so that you don't have to dump all your alcohol out. My alcohol is about gone. It's got some kind of stuff in it. Let me set up my camera better at a better angle so you can see. This is one of the cool finds I found at Walmart. It's a Nalgene type flask, plastic flask. It's in Outdoor Products, and they had them at Walmart. I just wrote alcohol, stove alcohol on there so nobody would think it was water and try to drink it. But this was a very cool find. I think it was like just $3 or $4, but it's a great way to hold your alcohol and keep it from spilling. Okay. Let's see if I can prime it a little bit. I put just a tiny bit on the edge, and that's where I'm going to strike it. So I'm going to be using one of my Sparklight fire starters. And all you do is just take it down and... Nope, didn't do it. There we go. Now it's lit. With alcohol, it's really kind of hard to see because it's a clear flame, so you gotta be really careful. I think it might have lit the first time I did it, but I didn't feel any heat. That warm up a little bit. Love that fire starter. Fantastic design. I wish I'd thought of that one. Now, I just also, by the way, the lid for this pot fits perfectly on the cups. So if you're making coffee or something and you want to keep the sticks and stuff out of it, or ashes, okay, just make sure I press that down into the ground so it's stable. And since I've dug a hole, I don't really need a windscreen. So that's kind of the good thing about doing it like that. This is the Pathfinder stainless steel bottle that I got this stove with. Nice thing about these pots is they are graduated, so you can see how much you're putting in it, and they're in ounces and milliliters, but they're actually graduated in ounces as far as a cup, and you know, 8, 12, 16. And there we go. Now I can put the lid on it and that'll speed it up. Coffee's about done. Now the water's about boiling. This is looking good. Wow. And water's ready for me to. It's ready. It's boiling. Yowie. That's hot. I might put another one in here since it's a big cup. sure I get my trash thrown away. A little bit of cream and sugar mixed together. Nice about the lids is you don't have to worry about bugs or sticks and stuff falling in. Or when you're cooking with a fire, the worst is the ashes. So, gotta find a stick to. That off. Looks like my alcohol stove burned all of the alcohol burned out of it. So I'll just let that cool off. Get the snuffer ring on there and make sure that dirt doesn't get in it. I'm going to go ahead and start filling this in. Now I'll put the leaves back down. You won't be able to even tell I was here. Thanks for coming along with me on this gorgeous day, looking for some fatwood and experimenting a little bit with the one-handed fire starters. Please subscribe if you haven't, like the video, and don't forget to check us out on Facebook at Wilderness Self-Reliance. Until we meet again, God bless. Obviously, I'm not out in the wilderness. I wanted to continue the video on the fatwood, so I'm processing it right here. This will just be a little addendum to the end of the video. It's real windy, and there's a lot of noises here. But I think this was a good part of, I need to put this in here to show you what you end up with, because I didn't show all that much before. Here's the pieces. Basically what you're getting is I cut off the ends of the branches on a fallen, these were all red pines. And I apologize for this wind noise, I'm sure it's pretty bad. I might have to move into somewhere quieter, like the garage, or just to continue a little bit more with this video. This is a quieter spot, and so I had to sneak over here to the garage to finish this, but I wanted to show you what you get when you are looking for fatwood, at least the way I do it. And I have been more successful in New York getting fatwood out of the broken off branches of old dead pine trees rather than finding a pine stump and digging it out. So I'll show you some of the things I did. Let me reposition the camera. I've cut some of these off, and I just used, if I know I'm going to be batoning wood, I always go for my SERC5 because it's a quarter inch thick steel and it can handle it. But this is pine, but because it's loaded with resin, it's a little more hard than normal pine. Here's another tip for you. You need a handhold for bow drill. This is perfect. The reason why is because of the resin in it will cause it to quickly burnish, and then it won't drill anymore. So this is better than most other things. Oh, here's what they look like when it's really rotted. This is the part that goes inside the tree. So all I'm doing is just splitting it. You can hear how hard that is. Now look at that. That's really good sapwood that's loaded.
What you doing?
What I'm doing is I'm
What?
I've got